Whew, that feels good. We solved everything.
Not everything. So we handled the two relatively easy cases, though that second one I admit is was a little bit more of a workout. The next one is going to be conceptually trickier, but the algebra is not going to be much worse. And this is going to be in the context of reward shaping. So have you heard this phrase reward shaping before? It comes up often when people are talking about, wow, how did they train that dolphin to jump through a hoop? So it's tricky to imagine how you might have gotten a dolphin to jump through a flaming hoop out of the water and then splashing down on the other side, because it's not the kind of thing where if you were going to train it, you can't tell it what to do, because they tend not to listen unless you go, and you can't reward it just for having done the right thing, because if you have this flaming hoop up in the air and you just wait for the dolphin to jump through it and you give it a treat, plus one if it does it, and otherwise you just don't give it a treat, it's never going to figure that out. It's never going to inadvertently kind of hop through that hoop and say, hey, do I get a reward? So how do you suppose they actually train dolphins to do this?
I have no idea, but I'm going to guess about how they do this because I'm not as into dolphins as you apparently are. And so I'm assuming what they do is they have to coax the dolphin to jump through the hoop in the first place by making it worth his or her while to do. So you kind of reward it maybe for jumping first and then getting near the hoop without the fire, with the fire. You just keep giving it, kind of rewards for getting close enough until it, rather than inadvertently jumping through the hoop, decides that that must be the right thing to do now.
Yeah, I think that's some approximation of what I imagine that they do. My understanding is that they'll start off with something like, you put the hoop in the water and you put a fish next to the hoop, right? So that the dolphin swims over and eats the fish. And then you start saying to the dolphin, well, you start changing when you pay off the dolphin. You don't give it fish for just touching the hoop or for being near the hoop. You give it a fish for actually touching it with its nose, and then you lift it out of the water a little bit, and then it has to, swim faster to get up to it, and then you lift it out of the water a little more, and it has to jump all the way through, and then, yeah, once it's all the way at the top, eventually you can light it on fire, I guess. I actually don't think I've ever seen a dolphin jump through a flaming hoop, so we might want to extinguish some of that. But anyway, that's not really the point. The point is that it's this series of mini rewards along the route to the big payoff that helps provide the right kind of hints.
Grad school.
I'm going to say life. You don't have to just say grad school. Like, most of the things that we do are like this. We don't wait to get the big reward after we've inadvertently done the desired behavior. We get hints along the way.
You've clearly never met any of my students, but okay.